then have some service, electronic service or information to deliver, then this sort of connectivity is not adequate. And actually no service can be given using this kind of dial-up modem connectivity. Now we can see the cellular access. The cellular network has now countrywide coverage, that's true. And we can also get internet using the GPRS wireless modem, and that is also used widely right now. And subscription and modem cost is little higher than PSTN counterpart. But the download speed, regular speed, is actually 57.6 kbps, and upload speed is only 14.4 kbps. And this is the default on class 8. That means if we are getting 4, because in each channel we have actually 8 slots, 8 time slots, and if we get 4 slots per internet user for download and 1 slot per internet user as upload, so this is the one slot is actually giving us 14.4 kbps speed. So that means if we want to actually give a service, then I'm not even getting that 57.6 kbps. I'm only getting for uploading, because for giving the service, everything will be considered as upload. So people will request me and I'm going to upload either service or content, whatever it is. My speed is only 14.4 kbps. Definitely you can actually get more channels or something like this than you are paying that much. That means you have to, if you want to multiply your connectivity, then you have to pay it multiple times. And now if you look at the edge modem, it has 236.8 kbps speed, and it's 4 times better than GPRS, but still it is less than TEON or EON connectivity. And TEON connectivity has actually 1.54 megabit per second, or EON connectivity has 2.048 megabit per second. And this is actually required for any kind of service that we want to give. And then even if you want to give it like a greater service, kind of like video or other things, then this TEON or EON connectivity is not enough. So we thought, like we can say, because sometimes, why I'm saying this, sometimes even the GPRS or AS connectivity provider, they are saying like we are giving the broadband, like cellular broadband. But if you just go for the like typical definition of broadband, anything that is more than 64 kbps is called broadband. So this is the thing they are using to say their connectivity is broadband, but you already saw the AS is given 57.6 kbps, and the AS is given 236 kbps or 240 kbps, and the GPRS is given 60 kbps, something like this. But if you want to deploy some service, those 240 or 60 kbps is not enough, though this is actually falling into the category of the broadband connectivity. So we need some broadband that is actually the high level broadband, and that is more than like 1.5 megabit per second, or EON connectivity that is 2.048 megabit per second. Now we can look at what are the options we have for broadband. We can have one option, TEON or EON, then DSL, that stands for digital subscriber line, then the cable, and optical fiber, Wi-Fi, WiMAX. So let's see what is the options in TEON or EON. This is, you at the beginning, this is actually the copperware dedicated line from your service provider, that means internet service provider, coming to your home. So you are not using the telephone company anymore. So this is your copperware, and you are getting this speed 1.5 or 2.048 Mbps megabit per second if you have that dedicated wire. And that might be enough to serve some of your clients, if you are actually providing any service as a government or a business organization to the citizen or to other business or to other government. And you can assume if you want to lay the copper wire, even right now, like T1 or E1 is coming by the fiber, it can be by the copper, but if you want to lay either fiber or copper, and if it is coming through the municipality or Dhaka City Corporation or other city corporation, then what you have to do, you have to take permission from many, many organizations. And not only that, you have to maintain those things, because this copper or this line will come through many private property or public property. So if something is going on, then your service is interrupted. So that's the, even not only that, the installation cost is very high, because you need to install this copper, and if you are living far away, then your installation cost will be even higher, and monthly cost for this kind of subscription is even higher. Now if you go to the digital subscriber line, in this case you don't need to lay down your own copper or own fiber. Whatever telephone line you have at your home, that you can use, and you can use both, like internet and the telephone, using the same cable. Only thing that you have to have, that is your DSL modem at your home. And this is giving you always on connectivity. And you, but if you want to get this service, and then the telephone company has to install DSLAM in their central switch office. And sometime, and they say the DSL is giving, if it is a symmetric DSL, that means if you are having the same speed, that is upload and uplink and downlink, that is 2.048 megabit per second. And there is another type that is called very high speed or DSL, that can give actually 52 megabit per second uplink and 2.3 megabit per second, 52 megabit per second downlink and 2.3 megabit per second uplink. So these might be adequate for many business, but these two options, like SDSL, that is the symmetric DSL, both uplink and downlink are same, or the very high speed DSL are not widely deployed. The most deployed kind of DSL is asymmetric DSL, or sometimes you can see as ADSL, and this is giving only 1.5 megabit per second downlink. And uplink, 128 kbps. So if you want to provide a service, this is not enough. But maybe this broadband connectivity is enough for the citizen to take the service, because they are getting 1.5 Mbps download speed, that is maybe enough for them. But as a service provider, if you are actually giving a service, digital service or digital business, then this is not enough for you. 128 kbps is the uplink. So that is the bottleneck. And as I say, if a telephone company wants to give this